In this video, I'm going to show you how we can plot the drawings. That is a fancy word for print. When we're doing it in AutoCAD, we call it plotting the drawings. Other words that you'll hear was plot, publish, print. Those words are kind of used kind of interchangeably. Before we get started, I'm here in Blackboard, and I just want to point out a few things to you that we're going to need in order to be able to do this. First of all, in our homepage in Blackboard, look up here and you'll find your synonym number. The course that I happen to be in is 19080. You'll have 5 digits. That's your synonym number. We're going to keep that in mind for when we're filling out the title block. But you do need to have a couple of things. Since we're going to publish this as a PDF, I want to make sure that you have a few things available to you. So click on that download links in Blackboard, and it'll pull this up. Two things that I want to make sure that you have. You've got to have the Google Drive file stream. If you haven't done it already, this was something we asked you to do at the beginning of the semester. If you haven't downloaded that yet, I need you to go ahead and do that. What that's going to do is it's going to take your student email, your student email comes with Google Drive. And I want you to save everything into your Google Drive. What Google Drive file stream is going to allow you to do is I'm going to click in here. Go to my Windows Explorer. It's actually making your Google Drive into its own separate drive or directory here on the computer. So I can easily go to my drive. I had my class create a folder. So you would just select a folder. I've got a few things in here. But this is where hopefully you've already done this. And hopefully this is where you're saving your DWG drawing files so far. The bracket, the shaft guide, and all of that. If that's not where you've been saving it, please download Google Drive file stream and put your files in here. But this is where we're going to be saving our PDFs. So it's important that you have that Google Drive file stream. That just makes it a directory on your computer that you can save to easily. The reason we want it here is it's the cloud, so it's good. It's automatically backed up whenever you do it. But also at the end of the semester, we're going to have you back it up so that we have a copy on our servers. So I definitely want you to do that. Another thing that I want to make sure that you have is Adobe Acrobat Reader. Since we're making a PDF, I need you to be able to see the PDF that you created. So if you don't yet have that reader, you can click right here. It's free. You just need to download it. So those are the two things I want to make sure that you have. Google Drive file stream set up. Whenever you set it up, you do need to log in using your ACC email address. And then after that, click here and make sure you have Adobe Acrobat Reader. If you already have Adobe Acrobat or any kind of PDF reader, that's fine. I want to make sure that you have that because you're going to need to see the PDF that you created. All right, now that we've got that, we're going to come right over here and we're going to jump into this. So I've got my bracket. Hopefully you've already watched the video on layouts, paper space, viewports, and all of that. So you're going to come into the bracket. You're going to fill this out. Drawing name, always use all caps, B-R-A-C-K-E-T, scale. This scale, I know what the scale is. I'm going to press escape. I'm going to click on that viewport, and I can see that I'm at a scale of 1 to 2. So 1, 2. I'm just double-clicking on this text to edit it. Let's see, 2, what is today, 26, 21, there we go. You're going to put your name in here. Initials are fine. If you have a long name that won't fit, you could do something like this. We just want to make sure that when you're filling this out, your initials, your name does not go out of the box right here. Feel free to grab this grip and move it, slide it over if you need to. You just want to make sure that you don't spill out past that border. Double click here. School name, we're going to type in, don't type in ACC, look what happens. We put this text in here with a fit option just so you could see. We define like start here, end here, make the text fit. So if you have something little, it's going to look kind of crazy. Look at that A. But if you, Austin Community College, there we go. This is where we want to make sure that we know what that synonym number is. So remember 19080. I'm going to come back here. We're going to type in DFTG space 1405 dot Now you're going to put whatever your course synonym number, 19080, whatever that five-digit number is. And then sheet, yours will say one of X. We want to make sure this says one of one. On future projects, right now we only have one layout. Future projects like our capstone, it'll say one of, if there's three pages, for example, it'll say one of three, two of three, three of three. So if this looks good, we've filled all of this out. Also make sure, I talked about this in the other video, but when you're trying to edit this, if you accidentally click off that text and you double click, you just put yourself in a model space. So you'll have to jump back into paper space to be able to fill out that title block. So this looks good. If your title block is filled out, please do make sure you have your notes. We got to know that it's mild steel. We have to know how to interpret these dimensions. Make sure that you've got everything showing up exactly the way that you need it. Now what we're going to do, we're going to make a PDF. There are a bunch of ways to make a PDF. There's no wrong way or right way to make a PDF. I'm going to show you how we're going to do it in this class, but if you know of another way to make a PDF, you're welcome to use that way as well. I'm going to take you to the Output tab. I'm going to click on the word output. And what we're going to do is we're going to do a batch plot. So, and that is actually another word for publish. The screen actually says publish here. So you could type in the word publish if you wanted to and get to that. But we're going to publish to a PDF. You can see it automatically pulls up all the drawings that I have open. Right now, I've just got bracket open. It's the name of the drawing, bracket, and the name of my layout is also called bracket, coincidentally. So that's why it named it this. But this is good. So looks good. I'm going to make sure this is a really big deal. I think by default, it's set to this, publish and background. I want to uncheck this and check this where it says open in viewer when done. This is really important because when you're done publishing that PDF, I need it to open up so you can look at it and make sure it looks how you want it to look. You would never, ever, ever submit anything to your teacher, to your instructor, to your boss, your clients. You would never submit something to somebody without looking it over to make sure that it looks the way that you need it. So here we can just go ahead and say publish. One thing that I'm going to go ahead and say publish, we're going to come back and talk about something, but I'll say publish here. You give it a name. So this will be bracket PDF. This is where it's important to have that Google file stream. You're going to pull this down, find your Google Drive, click on the folder, hopefully that you made for your class. And we're going to call this bracket.pdf. I also put, you can do this. You can put your Google Drive here just to get to it quickly. There we go. I'm going to select, say, okay, looking good. Takes a little while. It opens up in my publisher. This is, remember when I said I was going to show you something else? I forgot to show you to set it to monochrome. So we're going to come back and set it to monochrome. Maybe this is good. I'm going to pretend like I did this on purpose so you can see what happens if you accidentally did not set it to monochrome. So this is it. I made a PDF. This is what's really great. Actually, I kind of, this is good that it came in not in monochrome, it's in color, because when it opens up, it's kind of in my face. I can look it over. Are all my layers on? Yes. Do I have all my notes? Is everything printing? Yes. Is it in black and white? No. So, I need to go back. I'm going to close this out. I'm going to come in here and go to my bracket. I'm going to right click, go to my page setup manager, and I'm going to modify. If you do this the plain old print way, then you'll see this. This is actually the same looking window as your print or plot window. But in here, we're going to tell it we want it to be Microsoft to a PDF. We want it to be letter size. We want to print the layout. So where this is all good, just make sure the only thing that might be different at your house is this guy right here. But up here, this is what we did not set, monochrome. We're going to pull this down and set it to monochrome. Monochrome makes it black and white, and we definitely want it to be black and white. You will not, absolutely not, submit things in color. So we're going to set that to monochrome, make sure that says PDF. We're going to say OK and close, and I'm going to close that out. Now I'm going to do it all over again. Batch plot looks good. Open in viewer, publish. Once a name, we're going to do that same thing. Go to our Google Drive in here, And here, I'm going to give it the same name, and it's going to say, hey, do you want to replace that one? Yes, I do. Just replace that with the good one. Replace the bad one with the good one. Do-do-do. There it is, looking good. So you do have that educational stamp on it, and that's totally fine. Everybody has that stamp. I have that stamp. We're all using the educational version. So that is A-okay. Everybody's just going to have that. Don't feel like you have to take that out. But now I can see I've got it in monochrome. Looks good. I've got all the layers on. Yeah, this looks good. So now that you have this saved and you know that you've got it saved into your Google Drive through your Google file stream, now you're ready to submit this. So when it comes time to submit your project, let's go back over here. Let's go into, let's say, chapter 5. Scroll down till I get to the bracket. Each one of these projects is set up to have boop, 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 all the way at the bottom. See, look, I've already walked you through it. That's how you fill out your title block. This is pictures of what I just showed you. Go to output, go to batch plot, publish to. If you have two layouts, I'll talk about that in a second. We've got that, and then open here. There is a check print available. You can talk to your instructor about that. But right here, submit at the very bottom, submit bracket. Looks good. It tells you how many points are possible. It tells you a few things. Make sure you have all of that. And then you're just going to browse. You're going to go find your bracket in your course folder, bracket PDF, open, and submit. That's it. That's how you're going to submit it to your instructor. So that's how you're going to make the PDF. That's how you're going to submit the PDF to your instructor. Now let's go back to AutoCAD, and I want to show you something else. If I happen to have multiple files open, let me go find, here we go, this one. Here's our check print. This one has layout one, layout two. This one has just one called bracket. So when I go in here, if I have multiple files open, if I say batch plot, look, it's got bracket with a bracket layout. It's got bracket check print, layout one, bracket check print, layout two. If you happen to have multiple files open, it's going to grab the layouts for all of those drawings. So just select it, click the little minus sign. Select this, click the little minus sign. We only need one layout for the bracket or for each one of these projects that we're about to do, but do make sure that it says open in viewer and then you'll say publish right there. So that is it. You're gonna just repeat these steps. It's super quick and easy. I know this is a longer video, but it was going into more. Ooh, low battery. But yeah, we're just gonna batch plot, you're going to make it into a PDF, and then you're going to submit that PDF through Blackboard. All right, I hope that helped, and look forward to seeing you guys yard your drawings. Good luck.